So Modern Warfare reveal was about a week ago, and you know, I've gotten a lot of questions on my own opinions on this game, what I liked, what I disliked, what I think needs to be fixed. And since I've been getting those so much in my live streams and even on some of my videos, I decided to sit down and make this video before, you know, the beta comes out, which is like about a month from now. So now is like the best time to make this video. So before we jump into it though, I'm gonna have a lot of beta codes for you guys. I'm gonna throw one up on screen right here if you guys want it. And if you guys need a beta code, make sure you guys drop a like and also subscribe. Let me know down in the comment section what's something you guys are concerned about with Modern Warfare, and also what is something you guys like about it, or if or whatever. But nonetheless, let's jump into this. We're just going to talk about the big elephant in the room: no mini map. So yeah, when we played this game, as you guys can tell, there is no mini map in this game. The only time you could get a mini map is if you got a personal radar, which is at 3 kills, a UAV at 4 kills, or an advanced UAV at 12, and if you were running hardline, those are just one less kill. So 2 kills for a UAV if you're running a hardline line with personal radar, it's not that bad. I felt myself not knowing exactly where I was at, not knowing where the spawns were at. It was just kind of like all over the place, and I just think they need to add the minimap. I personally am all for adding a minimap to Modern Warfare. I just think that's how Call of Duty is. That's how it's been, and taking that minimap away just slows down the game. They did mention that there's two things they're going to be doing with this minimap situation. Is one, this was not in the build that we played, but apparently Infinity Ward came out and said that when the full game releases, you're actually going to be able to see your teammates through the wall, so you'll know where all your teammates are at. So that's kind of like Team Link from Black Ops 4, if you guys remember that perk. I use that when I'm playing hardcore and stuff like that. So it's not really a fix, but it is something very small that lets you at least know where your teammates are, kind of like where you guys are spawning and whatnot. And also, they did mention that during the beta, they're going to be taking feedback regarding the minimap. So make sure you guys voice your opinions. And that's also why I wanted to make this video, let you guys know that I'm for a minimap. It needs to be added to the game. Another thing that was recently announced from Infinity Ward, that's why I'm actually kind of glad I made this video like a week after the fact, is that we've gotten so much more intel on this. As you guys know, all the streaks in the game are kill streaks. So it's back to how, you know, Modern Warfare 2 was, where, you know, you'd actually have to get kills, not score, to get your actual streaks. Well, they came out and said that there's actually also going to be a way to convert those into score streaks, but I'm pretty sure it doubles everything. So for example, the Juggernaut is 14 kills, I believe 14 or 15 kills in Modern Warfare as of right now. And if you switch that to score streaks, I believe it's like 2,400 scores. So, you know, it's either going to be 14 kills or 2,400 score, which is kind of a lot. But at the same time, I kind of like the trade-off. If someone wants to switch this up so that they can play objective and be rewarded, then all for it. I personally like the kill streak idea a lot more, but that's also what I want to talk about. You can actually only get one set of streaks per life, and I think this is a wrong move. I just think it's going to slow down Call of Duty, especially if they stick to their guns and do no minimap. Imagine if you go on like a 30 kill streak or whatever, and you only get one UAV, one advanced UAV, a personal radar. You're basically, if you want to have that minimap, you are kind of forced to run at least a UAV, which, you know, a UAV for 30 seconds and then you're done. So I really hope that they decide to cycle through the streaks so you can earn them multiple times in one life. I just think that's the way to do it. It's how Call of Duty has been recently, and it's just a lot better when you can go on those streaks and grab multiple streaks. And in addition to me talking about the kill streaks and then them also switching it into score streaks, they also added the specialist strike package. So before anyone freaks out, I'm not talking about specialists like Black Ops 4 or Black Ops 3 or any of those. If you guys played Modern Warfare 3, that's where it started. Specialist basically is a way for you to earn more perks and make yourself kind of like a god soldier. This is giving me a real big Modern Warfare 3 vibes of being able to choose between the specialist, the, you know, score streaks, and also with kill streaks, because that's kind of like how Modern Warfare 3 was. So, you know, just them adding specialists makes me so excited to play this even more. So now core gameplay. So 6v6, 10v10 felt amazing. It just felt like Call of Duty, and it felt just super, super smooth. Having the gunsmith and having the variety of classes that you can actually make, you know, choosing between having a stock or having like a rear stock, switching your AUG from an SMG to an AR, switching the AK-47 to an AK-74U, or switching it to the RPD. There's so much customization in this game, and I love that. I do believe that the gunsmith is going to add so much variety to this game. There's times where maybe putting attachments on a weapon is going to make it worse, or putting certain amounts of attachments is going to be worse, because you can have 5 attachments per, you know, weapon, but that doesn't mean you have to use all 5. Because back in the day, in every other Call of Duty, attachments really never gave you a negative. They always just gave you a positive. You know, extended mags just gave you more ammo. Well, in this game, if you throw an extended mags, it may slow you down because then you're heavier, because you have more ammunition on your guy. And so I like the idea of that. I like how it's going to be pick and choose. You really get to make the gun your character. Like, that's what they're aiming for, is making the gun, making what you're using the main character of the game. And I really think they nailed it with the gunsmith. It's just so amazing. You can even turn in like a pistol to a sniper, or a shotgun with a sniper scope on it. There's just so much crazy stuff, and I'm so excited to being able to see the full build with more weapons, because what we saw wasn't even all of the weapons. One more thing I wanted to touch on is field orders. So these field orders are kind of like your power up, but they're not good by any means. Okay, before anyone freaks out, it's not like an OP power up. So for example, you can choose have a tactical insert as your power up or whatever, or a trophy system, or ammunition where you can get a random gun with more ammo in it, or stopping power rounds, which gives you one magazine, only one, not the entire gun, only one magazine of extra damage. So you could pick up a pistol, you could have a pistol out with 7 shots and then pick up the stopping power rounds, and you will only have 7 stopping power rounds. Or you can pick it up for your AK-47 and, you know, any other weapons. So they're really balanced and they're not really super OP. The stopping power rounds is probably what most people will run, just because it gives you that extra killing power. 6v6, 10v10, it plays like Call of Duty. I'm glad that they're bringing back bigger game modes. Like, I've wanted Ground War ever since they took it away in Black Ops 3 for some reason. And I remember when they added it in Infinite Warfare, it was fun. When they added it in World War 2, it was fun. And we still don't have it in Black Ops 4, unfortunately. But I've always been a fan of the big team battle game modes. I love it. But 20v20, like I said, it just played a little bit differently, mainly due to the fact that not having the radar, everyone was sweating for, you know, gameplays for their channel. You know, the experience that I had, I didn't have the craziest amount of fun playing it, but that doesn't mean it's not fun. I actually did enjoy it. It's just I enjoyed the 6v6 and 10v10 over that, in my personal opinion. And then, you know, also the streaks in the 10v10, the streaks in general are really good in this game. Like, they're actually, they feel rewarding. The juggernaut looks insane. The AC-130 is good. I got the chopper gunner, I think, once or twice. You know, using the white phosphorus gas is actually really cool. But nonetheless, gameplay-wise and all that, I like it. It was really, really fun. They did mention that the 20v20 was actually not the cap for the amount of players that they're actually going to have. They did tease a 50v50 mode, which, if everybody's comparing or anybody says, like, this game reminds them of Battlefield, the only time I got Battlefield vibes was in the 20v20. So, you know, the 20v20 was chaotic and crazy, and like I said, I didn't enjoy it the most when I was at the event, but that doesn't mean I didn't like it. But I'm curious to see how 50v50 plays, especially if they decide to add the minimap back in. So yeah, I don't know. It would be really, really interesting. And, you know, we also played a game mode called Realism. So basically, Realism is on night maps. So as you guys can see in the gameplay, we're playing, we have night vision goggles on, and there's no map, there's no HUD, there's literally nothing. It's just you and your gun and at night. So it gets kind of intense. It was really only fun, though, for about a game. After that, it kind of got stale, kind of got boring, in my personal opinion, just because it was kind of slow. In this, your body health has, you know, normal. It takes a couple shots to kill somebody, but headshots are 100% lethal. So you could literally just be walking around, hit a little headshot every single time with any weapon, and it's realism. You get one shot to the head, you're going to get the kill. So, and one main thing that I think is more important than even the launch of this game is the post-launch. You guys can look at Black Ops 4, for example. It was super hyped up. Everyone was excited for this game. Then they launched the game and the post-launch has been awful. Just horrible microtransactions. You know, outfits that we get in the game really don't look that good. We rarely get any cool camos. And when we do, it's just all hidden behind a paywall. Like, there's literally everything you just have to buy. If they follow the same pattern that Black Ops 4 did, this game will not, it would just fail. It will fail if it does exactly what Black Ops 4 did. They need to do something different. The post-launch, in my opinion, is almost, if not more important than the launch of the game, because you can hype up a game as much as you want, but if after you upload or after you get the game out there, people start playing it and then they realize like the BS that's behind it, they're not going to play it anymore. Like, the fan base dies, and then there's just not really much to do. So, like I said, I think the post-launch of this game is super, super important. And, you know, as long as they offer free content like they're saying that all DLC maps are going to be free. So, hopefully, there's no scummy microtransactions with weapons hidden behind supply drops. You know, like I said, Activision could ruin this game. But, you know, nonetheless, hopefully, they really don't, because I just want this game to succeed. I like playing Call of Duty. I had a really good, enjoyable experience playing this game. But overall, with what I played, I really enjoyed the game. But like I said, take it all with a grain of salt. This could be the honeymoon phase. You got to remember that is always a thing when Call of Duty comes out, is the first, like, you know, initial time playing it. It's really fun. But like I said, there's going to be a beta September 12th. It's going to be an open beta. So give it your shot right there. Hopefully they listen to the feedback and hopefully they add mini maps to the game. And I just wanted to give you guys my opinions on the game, what I think is wrong, what I think they should change, and all that good stuff. So I appreciate all the support on the channel. Like I said, I apologize for not uploading for 6 days. I was just sick, and then, you know, a mixture of just tech issues ran in. But nonetheless, thank you guys so much for the support on the channel, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.